Precisamente son 50 años de la marcha por los derechos civiles. ¿Cómo podría hacerse ese balance de esos 50 años de esa lucha por el mejoramiento del estatus de la población, en este caso la población afrodescendiente, pero ahora hay una nueva que es la población latina que cada vez crece más en Estados Unidos?
He says, precisely now is 50 years from the March on Washington, and over the time, how do you see that, let's say, since then, how have things improved for Afro-Americans and also now for Latin Americans in the U.S., let's say?
Well, I think when you look at how things were for people of color in the United States 50 years ago, and if you then flip immediately today to today, you see an enormous change. But it's taken too long. And there's been day after day after day, and week after week, and year after year of struggle to get to where we are today. My father held a meeting with Harry Belafonte and Lena Horne and some members of Martin Luther King's staff just before the March on Washington. And it was a very tough meeting. And at the end of that meeting, my father said, in two generations that his family had gone from being abhorred immigrants to his brother becoming president of the United States. And he said to them, in 40 years, an African American will become president of the United States. And when you hear that, now, that sounds like a great thing. But at the time, it seemed to the people in that room that that was way too long. And they were right. It is too long.
Okay. Básicamente está diciendo dos cosas. Primero, compara, si tú ves hace 50 años exactamente y vienes a hoy, el cambio es drástico, hay una diferencia enorme. Pero realmente tomó demasiado tiempo, o sea, si lo mides como 50 años. Dice, justo antes de la marcha en Washington, su papá se reunió con Harry Belafonte y Lena Horne y otros miembros de la comitiva de Martin Luther King. Y él les dijo a ellos que él, su familia, 40 años antes, había sido negada, o sea, rechazada, y que hoy en día su hermano es presidente de los Estados Unidos. Él dijo, igualmente, él lo dijo en dos generaciones, y él dijo, igualmente yo espero en 40 años que haya un presidente afroamericano de los Estados Unidos. En ese momento, la gente le parecía que era demasiado tiempo, pero realmente, o sea, si vemos la historia, es una realidad, o
Ocurrió
sea,
así.
ocurrió así.
En el caso de los Kennedy eran los orígenes irlandeses y su
Irlandesa
religión
y
y
católico.
católico. ¿Podría entonces hacerse una aproximación y pensar que un latino podría llegar a ser presidente de los Estados Unidos?
Okay. He says, in the case of the Kennedys, they were Irish, and I said, Irish and Catholic.
Yes.
And he says, well, what do you think, asking you, of a Latin American or a Latin descendant becoming president of the United States?
Oh, I think there's no question that that's going to happen,
Que
and it's going to happen soon.
no hay duda que eso va a pasar y va a pasar
Okay.
pronto.
There's still no question that Americans of Latino descent or Latin descent are still suffer prejudice in the United States, and all you have to do is look at our immigration laws, and you need look no further, and we absolutely have to make changes, real changes. But when you look, I live in Los Angeles, California, and the mayor of Los Angeles is Latino. When his great grandfather was a citizen of Los Angeles when there were only a few thousand people living there, and they were shunted aside for the last 80 years. Now he's the mayor of the city, and he was a member of a gang when he was growing up, you know, of a street gang. And when he was a teenager, there was very little opportunity for Latin Americans. And this was at a time, you know, when President Kennedy was elected. And I think in the United States, when my Uncle Jack was elected president, there was really a split, and America was really two different countries. And I think that the people who were in power, who were in control, had almost no sense at all of the people of color, and people who were poor and people who were shut out of the political system. And I think as we saw these incredibly courageous people going down and fighting against segregation in the South, and that kind of, in a way, culminating in the Civil Rights March, we began to have this extraordinary awareness of the nation as separate. And I think the work of my father was really to try to bring the country together and make it one country.
Okay.
Are you going to be able to do that?
No, voy a empezar desde atrás, o sea, porque realmente lo que está diciendo es que cuando vino su tío a la presidencia, su tío Jack, los Estados Unidos estaba dividido en dos partes y la gente que estaba en el poder no tenían idea de la segunda parte, o sea, no se daban cuenta diariamente de la situación de la gente pobre, del afroamericano, de la gente latina, o sea, de la situación en que vivían. Vino el presidente Kennedy y en ese momento, cuando empezó el movimiento de derechos civiles, el movimiento que culminó en la marcha en Washington, se empezó a visualizar lo que estaba pasando, lo que estaba dividido el país. Entonces, su padre, Robert Kennedy, fue después de que murió su hermano, trató de unir esas dos partes. O sea, él hizo un gran esfuerzo. O sea, yo creo que, esto es mi parte, en la última campaña de él, ese era una unificación a través de la juventud.